The first statement says negative correlation between overall sizes and the mileages. The best way to solve these questions is to always first look at the maximum and the minimum values. The maximum mileage is here. So if there were a negative correlation, we would expect the size of this car to be the lowest. Yes, the height is lowest. The width is not the lowest, but okay, it's one of the lowest. The length is also the lowest. So probably here this sounds true, but we cannot reach an answer based on only one value. The best way is to then look at the minimum value. 7.8 is the minimum value. So in this case, we would expect the size to be highest. So see, this is not highest. There are two cars with greater lengths. This is also not highest. There are two cars with greater width. And this is in fact one of the lowest values here. So definitely the car which has the lowest mileage is not the biggest car, and therefore a negative correlation cannot be established. You can look further, but it is not actually needed. The answer is going to be false here. The second statement, a negative correlation between the maximum powers and their seating capacities. So let's sort it by seating capacity. As the seating capacity is increasing, the maximum power is actually decreasing. Yes, see, there is a clear negative correlation. This is increasing and this is decreasing. So yes, we can say true. The last statement, a bigger engine does not necessarily lead to a greater power. So now let's sort it by engine. And we see as the engine size is increasing, the power is not necessarily increasing. See, the first time only it decreased. It decreased further and then it increased. So there is no correlation, negative or positive. So yes, this does not necessarily lead to a greater power. This statement can also be considered true. So the right combination of answer choices is false, true, true.